The blonde girl in Thornton's bedded the wicker basket with rustling fiber. Blazes Boylan handed her the bottle swathed in pink tissue paper in a small jar. "Put these in first, will you?" he said. "Yes, sir," the blonde girl said, "and the fruit on top." "That'll do. Game ball," Blazes Boylan said. She bestowed fat pears neatly, head by tail, and among them ripe, shame-faced peaches. Blazes Boylan walked here and there in new tan shoes about the fruit-smelling shop, lifting fruits, young, juicy, crinkled, and plump red tomatoes, sniffing smells. HELYs filed before him, tall white-hatted past Tangier Lane, plodding toward their goal. He turned suddenly from a chip of strawberries, drew a gold watch from his fob, and held it at chain's length. "Can you send them by tram? Now?" A dark-backed figure under Merchant's Arch scanned books on the hawker's car. "Certainly, sir. Is it in the city?" "Oh, yes," Blazes Boylan said. 10 minutes. The blonde girl handed him a docket and a pencil. "Will you write the address, sir?" Blazes Boylan at the counter wrote and pushed the docket to her. "Send it at once, will you?" he said. "It's for an invalid." "Yes, sir. I will, sir." Blazes Boylan rattled merry money in his trousers pocket. "What's the damage?" he asked. The blonde girl's slim fingers reckoned the fruits. Blazes Boylan looked out into the cut of her blouse. A young pullet. He took a red carnation from the tall stem glass. "This for me?" he asked gallantly. The blonde girl glanced sideways at him, got up regardless, with his tie a bit crooked, blushing. "Yes, sir," she said. Bending archly, she reckoned again fat pears and blushing peaches. Blazes Boylan looked in her blouse with more favor, the stalk of the red flower between his smiling teeth. "May I say a word to your telephone, missy?" he asked, roguishly.